Maybe I'm going through a drought. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on with just a touch. Hello, hello, every single one of you. Yes, I know, sorry about that. Good evening to each and every one of you. Now, this is a beautiful, beautiful, amazing session that I know for a fact is going to turn your entire perspective of storytelling around, okay? Hopefully, we should be able to do extreme justice to this kind of an interaction today. So I want each and every one of you to please set an intention for today's session. What's your intention for today's session? I want you to type it out in the comment box right now. What is your intention for this evening session? Can you please type it out in the comment box right now? That would be amazing so that I can see what exactly are people here wanting to do. Okay, drive hard to progress. Fantastic. Catching up. That's cool, Sahil. Thank you very much for making this step happen. And congratulations on becoming papa. That's really, really awesome. It's one of the best phases of life, I can assure you. All right. So let's see. To become impactful in your communication. Fantastic. Leveling up my passion. Ooh, nice. Deep concept about storytelling knowledge. Okay, learn while having fun with storytelling. Yes, 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 absolutely. That is the story here today, learning something which I can implement in my day-to-day life. Fantastic, absolutely. Okay, so you know for a fact, all of you who are already here, you know for a fact that doors will close at 8:10 p.m. sharp, okay? So I need you to understand that just in case you get, you know, shunted out because of bad internet and things like that, I would like it for you to tell me right now in the chat box that your internet is a little all over the place, okay? Because sometimes we know we're constantly being thrown out. We know that our internet is faulty. And the other thing that you can do for sure is if you do get out of the of this particular room, then I want you to type out a message to me on WhatsApp. I've got it open. I wanted to type out a message telling me that I was in there, but because of internet, I got shunted out and I want to be back in. Okay. So I want you people to do that. Thank you very much to everybody who's going to do that. Now, let me just shut down this, this sound. Okay. All right. So let me start reading all your... Just give me a second, yeah, guys, because I know for a fact that there are people who are waiting and I just want to be able to admit everybody. All of these people who join in lastminute.coms. I mean, honestly, you are already late, by the way. When you are on time, you are late. It's only when you are before time that you are actually on time. Okay, I don't know whether you believe in that, but that's how I've learned things from my mentors. And I like to be everywhere about 10, 15 minutes early, at least 5 minutes early, if not 10, 15. If 10, 15 is like, oh my God, then at least 5 minutes early. That should be your intention and your aim at every single stage in your life. Okay. Okay. No problem. If your internet is fluctuating, then well, yeah, I'll get you back in when I see your name. Super. Now, drive hard to progress. Okay. Okay. I've read some of them. Deep concept, blah, 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 blah. I've read this. Learn something which I can implement. Cool. Cool. Learn as much as possible. Effective communicator. I want you, every single one of you, to set an intention for this evening's session. Everybody, I want you to set the intention. Please set the intention. I type out that intention in the comment box, because when we set an intention, we are allowing our focus to go in that direction. Wherever our focus goes, our energy flows. Intention, attention, manifestation. If this was a bulb on, then type out BO in the comment box. Intention, your attention goes there. Wherever your focus goes, your energy flows. So your attention goes there. Manifestation. Got it? So please set an intention for this evening's session. Today's session is going to be the best for my progress. Aradhana, fantastic intention setting. Effective communicator is your intention. Good, that's great. Internet is okay, but there is a power fluctuation. No problem, Dr. Anita. You'll have to just send me something on WhatsApp. But I've now that I've read your name, I have very good memory. Okay. That's all right. That's all right, Aradhana. I'll do that. To master emotional impact. Fantastic, Ayaz. That's a beautiful intention to set. Yes, very, very nicely put. Internet is very poor here. Okay, no problem. No problem. Ritu, I've seen you. You were there before at 7:30 when I had not even started the evening. So I like that enthusiasm. That's awesome. Okay. Be effective in my communication. Yes, for many of you, that was a bulb on, right? Intention, attention, manifestation. Oof, it's such a... Oh, I love this thought process of I'm a powerful creator. You're a powerful creator. Can you imagine? We can set our intention. We can let our focus and our energy flow there, and we can create anything under the sun. It's amazing. Okay. Be effective in your communication. Fantastic, Sukanya. Intention. Nice. Thank you. Learn how to be an effective storyteller. All right, I am. That's fantastic, Shri Gurav. Learning the art of storytelling, intention, attention, manifestation. Okay, focused implementation. I will become an awesome storyteller from today onwards, Jaya. That is fantastic. Effective communication. Learn something to upscale my communication skills after this session. Start nicely, including storytelling in all my interactions. Yes, Hema. Yes, that's what I want. Every single person should learn today and implement from tonight itself. Okay, whatever you want to share with your spouse, whatever you want to share with your children, share it in a storytelling format immediately after this session gets done. Yes, sharing thought in meaningful story. Fantastic. To master storytelling, become powerful storyteller. Beautiful. Want to be a master storyteller. Intend to have courage to be able to write the stories that I have in my... Wow, in your head. Fantastic, Asavari. That's a fantastic intention to set. Become awesome and engaging storyteller. That is beautiful. All righty. Effective and efficient implementing of storytelling to improve communication skills and impacting society around you. Beautiful. Become awesome and engaging storyteller. That is fantastic. Today I have started my storytelling course. First video was mind-blowing. Awesome. I'm so happy for you, Sugandh. Your story was really... Oh, thank you so much, Sugandh. Thank you so much. Yeah, I know. My story makes me cry also. Okay. Reconnect with my inner sense of childlike wonder by learning storytelling. Saurabh, you've hit the bullseye, my friend. Bachchon ko stories itni pasand hoti hain, and by the time we kind of get to a particular age, we forget that stories are beautiful, stories are pure, stories allow us to just kind of, you know, be a child again, right? And I really want all of you to be childlike in your lives. I really, really want each and every one of you to be childlike in your lives. Never, ever, ever lose the child in you. You know why I'm saying this? And I did not say childish. I said childlike. Being childlike keeps you young. Being childlike allows you to just experience the joys of life. Being childlike allows you to you know, throw out the clutter. Being childlike allows you to forget and forgive. Being childlike allows you to love stories, and stories win hearts. When you tell stories, you win hearts. Okay? So I want everybody to also start becoming a child today. Is that okay with you? Then give me CL in the comment box, which stands for childlike. Not childish, childlike. Bahut bada difference hai. Okay, thank you. Intend to face the camera with confidence, Ritu. That's fantastic. Due to traveling, no problem, Satish. That's all right. That's Asha. You haven't missed my story. You have to go to the recorded content. You have to go to the course called storytelling, and you have to Watch the recorded content, Baba. Without watching recorded content, you will miss more than half of the things that I share because a lot of things I share in my recorded content. Yes, that's magical, isn't it, Asabri, to be childlike? Everybody who's set the intention of being childlike from this day forward, also along with your intention of being a storyteller, type out CL in the comment box. And those who have typed it out, don't type out again. I'm an impactful storyteller and move masses with my message. Beautiful, Rukhiya. I love that intention. That's all right, Sri Gurav. Connect with others with authenticity and vulnerability. That's correct, Sharanya. And that's exactly what storytelling also allows you. But that's also something that being childlike allows you, right? Should I have listened to the recorded content first? No. None of that. I don't do listen first, then come and attend. I don't do any of that. Okay. So, all right. Are we all set? Are we all set? Let me see your beautiful faces once again, once before I start, because how sweet is that? I want to see some awesome smiling faces. And Osvi's got her little girl along saying, I want to be like my little girl. That's so amazing. I love you folks so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Can I say something to you people before we start storytelling today? I'm so overwhelmed by this. Can I say something to you people with all my heart? Do I have your permission? Give me PG in the comment box. Give me permission granted. That's all right. Don't worry. Don't need to listen to the recording. Don't need to watch the recording before this session. I feel super, super, super fulfilled. And every single day, I stand in front of my Almighty and I say thank you for each and every one of you. And I, every single day, stand in front of him and I pray that you are able to accomplish all your relationship goals, your professional goals, your financial goals, your personal growth goals with just that little help from me. That's my prayer for you every single day. So I love you people from the bottom of my heart more than I can ever express. I'm going to share something with you, which my mentor, Siddharth Rajsekhar, asked me one day. You know, I was sharing about you people to him. He's my mentor. I share everything with him. And he turned around and he said to me, he said, Pallavi, you love your community like you love your Gia, isn't it? And my Gia is 14, okay? And I looked at him at that point in time when he said that, and I had tears flowing down my eyes because he just knows that I love you people exactly how I love my little girl. So thank you, thank you, thank you for being part of my beautiful family, my being part of my heart on a moment-by-moment basis. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for receiving this with a lot of gratitude. And I shared this because this is how I am. I will share what I feel like sharing the moment I feel like sharing it. And I urge you to do the same because that is powerful. That is beautiful. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Ah, I love you too. I love you, each and every one of you. Okay. Let's get started. Okay. So, storytelling is extremely, extremely powerful. Yes. How many of you believe that? Thank you so much, Asbi. Thank you. Storytelling is extremely powerful, isn't it? Yes. And I want you to know exactly why I say storytelling is so powerful. I've not taken, 10 different ideas or 10 different things why storytelling should be used. No. I want you to understand that. Even if you have these top five reasons why stories should be told, why you should delve into this, I'm telling you, life is going to be at a different level altogether. It increases your engagement. So basically, any kind of a story captures people's imagination. It captures people from the word go. Facts and figures alone do not capture people's attention and they don't allow people to stay with you. But when you're staring, not staring, when you're sharing a story, your audience is immediately drawn into, even if it's a presentation that you're making and you're sharing that story through a presentation, your audience is immediately drawn in. Okay. And with the help of a story, they actually end up staying connected with you and engaged with you throughout your narrative. All right. So you need to, even if you're giving presentations in your offices, believe me when I say this, there is something or the other that could definitely be there. Something related to the numbers, something related to the sales team, something related to, the projections, something related to what happened with you and the bosses. Add that bit in when you are making that presentation. To how many of you this makes sense? Give me MS in the comment box if it makes sense to you, okay, what I just said, shared. Because some of you are in corporate, right? And some of you keep wondering, are what, yeah, in a hardcore presentation, where to add a story? Are Baba, it doesn't have to be a story from your life, na. It can just be a story connected to whatever you're sharing about. And you say, last week, it so happened that I was sitting with the team while I was trying to do this, trying to take out all this data that I'm sharing with you right now. And something so powerful came about as we were discussing this particular data. And then share. Sometimes you might even have to make up a powerful point. Of course, you might have shared, but you might have shared something very forgettable. Try and say it in a manner that it becomes unforgettable for them, or that it connects with the data, and then they say, ah, okay, now I'm going to remember this data because of the story that was attached to it. That's how they will remember it. I'm guaranteeing you this. Okay, so yes, that's exactly how you need to be doing this. So Nitin, I'm telling you, even with when you're sharing with venture capitalists, even when you're sharing with clients, they're all human beings, na, in the first place. Forget about them having that kind of money, they being such amazing clients, but the first thing they are human beings, and every single human being loves stories because that's how we've grown up. Yes. How many of you agree with me that that's how grown up? We've all grown up listening to stories, and we're still listening to stories. Do you realize it or not? Yes, absolutely. And it's a skill. Moshmi, it's a skill. Every single person can learn it starting at whatever age. Dadi nani ki stories. Correct. Dadi nani ki kahaniya. Absolutely right you are. But do you know that there are so many different stories, even in the fables, even in what we call our mythology, that can actually be used. Do you realize that? Yes, that's what I want you to have, that kind of a realization. The next thing I want to share about, sorry, the next thing I want to share about storytelling is it improves retention. Do you know when you share a story, people have, do you know what are the chances of retention of whatever you shared? Not just your story. You shared your story along with some data. Do you know what is the percentage of retention increase because of storytelling? It is 25%. 25% is massive. How many of you think 25% is massive? Give me massive in the comment box. Or just type out the letter N, M in the comment box if you think that 25% is massive. Yes. And this is exactly why I tell people that please, 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 okay, make sure that you people are definitely, definitely sharing stories when you people are with people. Getting it? Now, another thing that I want you to understand. So retention is so crucial, isn't it? And it's very, very difficult a lot of times. So when you are presenting your information as part of a particular story, even abstract data can be retained, okay? And when you structure it in a particular way that it connects with their emotions. See, stories connect with emotions. Data connects with the brain. But stories connect with heart, emotions, experiences. Yes? Give me HEE in the comment box if you got that. Heart, emotions, experiences. Everybody give me HEE if you got that. Because what do stories do? They connect with the emotions. Yes? If everyone agrees with me, then give me an HEE in the comment box. Yes? Awesome, awesome, awesome. You know what I'm doing at this point in time? I'm also along with you, along with speaking to you, sharing with your counterparts out there on your WhatsApp group. Look at the number of people learning about this. Why aren't you here? This is also a way of telling a story. Are you getting it? Now, this is very, very crucial for you people to be doing if you are coaches, if you are team leads. Understand that your people, whoever has missed it, they need to see what's happening. Why am I missing out? They need to feel, sometimes they need to feel FOMO as well. Okay. And that is when they're really going to Oh, the H-E-E is like he. Ah, that's fantastic. So people need to feel that they're missing out on something. That is also a form of storytelling. Got it? Now, the next thing that I want to share with you. So improves retention, yes, through the heart when you're sharing emotions, and then you're also allowing people to experience things. Even abstract data will be remembered more, and your message will be remembered for a much, much longer period. Not just till the presentation ends will people remember it, but for a much, much longer period. Next thing, of course, is it builds an emotional connect. Do you realize that nothing and nobody moves without emotional connection? How many of you are in sales and you can agree with me? And how many of you know this principle and you can agree with me? People are not moved by data. Data only adds credibility. People are moved to take action when they are emotionally moved. How many of you understand that when people are emotionally moved, that's when they take action? Do you know impulse buying? Impulse buying is not about data. Impulse buying is a lot to do with emotion. Us time pe, I felt like it and I bought it. Us time pe, that ad really appealed to me and I bought it. That at that point in time, that person said something and it tugged at my heart and I bought. How many of you have done this in your lives? And please understand, this is something I want you to use in your storytelling or in your lives, so that through storytelling, you can actually increase your closings. You can increase your sales. You can increase your emotional connect. So please understand how important this emotional connect is, my friends. Okay? That stories are the only one of those only things in the world that have that power to evoke those kind of emotions. And it's a very important aspect of a persuasion. It's a very important aspect of motivation. Okay. So you can share personal anecdotes. Now you can write this down if you'd like. You can share personal anecdotes, things that have happened in your life or things that you heard happen in the lives of the people around you. I'm not talking about known figures. Okay. I am talking about, sorry about that. Yes, I am talking about, people around you, those kind of people, if you can share stories of and anecdotes of, fantastic. Known figures, most people know their stories, but still it's okay to use their stories as and when it's important. Like if I want to talk about a story of communication, believe me when I say this, I will most certainly do this one thing. What? Use the story of Kangana Ranaut. How when she came into this industry, you know, she had such bad, forget the English and the pronunciation. She had a challenge with the way that her tongue, her lips, her jaw and her teeth used to interact with each other. There was a disability. And that lady today is such a revered actress. Sylvester Stallone had partial facial paralysis and he worked on his ability to speak. And that these are powerful stories. If they can do it, obviously you can become a world-class speaker, actor, whatever you choose to become. It's about what you choose to become. So don't turn around and tell me, actor, why would I want to be an actor? It's very late in my life. Really? Ask those people who have just started their acting career on OTT. Some of them are 55, some of them are 65, some of them are my friends. Therefore, I know their ages. Got it? So I'm just trying to tell you this. Yes, so there are loads and loads of inspirational stories. So you can pick up absolutely anything from anywhere and build that emotional connect through a very hardcore, like a proper PPT. Don't worry about it. It's really all right. It clarifies complex information. Yes or no? How many of you agree with me that when you tell stories, it can actually help people? You can simplify with the help of a story. Complex ideas and data can really be broken down. Everything can become a lot more relatable. And when it is a nicely well-crafted kind of a story, then you can actually be showing images and you can give some concrete examples for some abstract concepts and abstract data. You can give some concrete examples, and that makes your content and that makes your presentation yourself a lot more accessible to people around you. It makes it easier for the audience to understand you. It also, of course, makes it easier for them to appreciate you, my friends, because that's also very crucial when you want to present in front of people and you really want to be liked and people. And you want that people should take action, they should follow you. Believe me, your likability factor is very key. How many of you agree with me? Yes, Bhaman Irani's story is also such a beautiful one, right? One of my closest friends is married to Bhaman's eldest son. And believe me, that man's story is amazing. So, how many of you agree with me that you can actually clarify very, very complex things by using stories and make it very, very simple, simple, simple? How many of you agree with me? Yes? Fantastic. Thank you very much. How many of you also agree with me that it would be very nice as a person who's presenting to people to be appreciated for whatever you're sharing. And when will people appreciate you? When they understand you. Yes, when they can relate to you. That's when they appreciate you, isn't it? Now, it also enhances persuasion. That's the last reason why we want to share stories. Okay. So, guys, I'm going to tell you this upfront. We are going to do two sessions on storytelling. Okay, one session today with me. And believe me when I say this, the next session is going to be with Commander Bimal Raj on Saturday. It's going to blow your mind. So do not miss Saturday's session at 8:30 p.m. 8:30 p.m. to 10 p.m. 10:30, pakad lijiye. Please have your dinner, shinner on Saturday before that. 8:30 to 10:30 p.m. Just be with him. Today also, I'm telling you very openly, it's a session on storytelling. If we do not finish by 9:30, I'm guaranteeing you that I'm going to try and finish by 10 p.m. Okay? So please stick around if you want to stick around. Of course, if you want to go ahead and do your things, that's perfectly fine. I will not have anything against you. It's just that because it's interaction, people take a little time, right? Okay. So like I was already saying that it enhances persuasion. And here is where I want you to understand that stories are the most effective way to persuade people, to influence your audience. It is only by showcasing real life examples, your success stories, your failure stories, your maybe some kind of a hypothetical situation or a story that's happened in your family or a story that's happened with your mentor or people who are known people. When you provide the proof of concept, na, when you provide proof of concept through your storytelling that this has happened, this works. When you provide that and you demonstrate the possibilities, you are a possibility. If you're sharing your own story, then you become the possibility for that person. And that person says, wow, if she can do it, I can do it, man. Okay? So stories can very, very subtly convey some amazing points and arguments. And people don't really feel like they're being sold something when you're telling stories. People feel like you're just sharing your heart with them and expressing yourself fully to them. And that is when you are almost giving like an invitation to people that, hey, please see things from a new perspective. And that new perspective is my perspective. Can you please try and see things from this perspective? How many of you feel that these five reasons are solid, super solid reasons for you to be, to start becoming a world-class storyteller? Give me in the comment box. Type out me in the comment box. Yes. Fantastic, fantastic. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I'm very, very happy that you people truly feel that these five reasons are enough. And actually, they are enough. You don't need any more than these five reasons. Okay. So now let's get into one other very, very beautiful area of storytelling. Okay. Because it's not just why stories, we know why stories, it's being practiced from centuries, from ages. Why would we not want to use stories? Right. But how, what is the technique? Isn't that crucial? So there are many, many techniques in my recording that I have of storytelling, the content that I have given you. I've given you some, I think, 7 or 8 techniques of storytelling. Today, I'm going to only talk about 3 powerful techniques of storytelling. And I'm going to give you examples of the same as well. Are you ready for it? Give me ready in the comment box and give me ready with a lot of whys. Like type out ready with a lot of whys. Okay. So my first extremely powerful technique in storytelling for you is very simple. And this is something that a lot of amazing speakers, coaches, entrepreneurs use in order to, what do you say, in order to bring out the best in people. They use something called the hero's journey. Yes. Now, what exactly is the hero's journey? How many of you have heard of the hero's journey? How many of you know of about what I'm talking about? If you don't know, that's perfectly fine. If you know it, then just type out know it, K-I. If you don't know it, just type out D-K, don't know. Okay. Now, this particular type of storytelling became very, very popular because this gentleman called Joseph Campbell, he wrote this book called The Hero with a Thousand Faces. Can some of you find the resemblance or understand? Yes, we have a hero in our lives. But now, that hero, what do you think that happens to that hero's life? Do you think that that hero's life is very, very straightforward and very, ooh, awesome? Or that hero has multiple shades in his life. He goes through multiple ups and downs, thousands of faces, thousands of facets of his life. Yes. How many of you agree with me? Then give me an agree in the comment box. Because that is something that, yes. Yeah. Agree or just type out A. That's perfectly fine with me. Because so right in the name of the book itself, Joseph Campbell gave the world a beautiful thing called the hero's journey. This is something that allows you to understand a hero starts from somewhere. Nobody starts a hero. Nobody's a born hero. Ventures out into an ordinary world, so to speak. Okay, a hero ventures out into an ordinary world. And from that ordinary world, he wants to go to a supernatural world. He wants to go to, something that nobody else has ever forayed into. He wants to go to a place where people don't even know that this kind of a thing exists. How many of you know about the 4-minute mile? How many of you know the story of the 4-minute mile? What is the 4-minute mile? You know that 400 meters was called the mile. How many of you know the 4-minute mile? Give me. In the comment box. The people who know it, is what it was Jesse Owens. I'm forgetting the name of the athlete. So I'm very sorry that I have to reconfirm this. But chalo, I'm human. Ah, Roger Bannister. Thank you. Not Jesse Owens. Roger Bannister, before Roger Bannister, a lot of people had attempted that 1 mile running. Okay. And nobody could do it. It's a 1-minute mile, right? Yeah, 1-minute mile or 4-minute mile. What was it? I'm so sorry. Right now, I'm completely focused on something else. And I suddenly got this thought. That is why I'm sharing this story. 4-minute mile. Thank you. So Roger Bannister tried to do that mile or set out to do that mile under 4 minutes. And everybody said, no, that's not going to be possible because nobody had done it before that. The day Roger Bannister broke that barrier, he completed a mile under 4 minutes. That was the day he created history for sure. But the fact is that multiple people after that started breaking that 4-minute barrier. And that is what is a hero's journey. And he went through a lot of hardship. He was first and foremost, he was a colored athlete. It was a time in history when colored athletes were not really looked up to. They were not even preferred. Okay. So at that point in time, when he came as a hero and did something supernatural for the world out there, it was supernatural. This is not possible only. 1 mile to run under 4 minutes, not possible only. Got it? So when he went through the various tribulations, the various challenges that he faced, that's when he won that, and when he did it under 4 minutes, that mile, he himself was a transformed human being. And in him being transformed, he had transformed not just the people who were witnessing that life. He had transformed the world, because athletes all over the world started believing in the possibility of being as supernatural as Roger Bannister. And that, my friends, is what is a hero's story or a hero's journey. So when you can share your human experiences of, I want to do this, this is my dream, I've gone through certain trials and tribulations, I've gone through so many challenges, and then I'm transformed at the end of those challenges into this. And if I can do it, being human, then you can do it. And that makes it all relatable, that, hello, what is so special about this person? This person also comes and has the same, bones, blood, flesh, cells, everything is the same. Then what is the difference? It's the mindset. And it's that intention, that it's that big dream. And that's what makes it relatable, that, array, if the physical thing is the same, then the mental is all I need to work on, and I definitely can work on this. Yes. How many of you are with me so far? Give me a WU in the comment box. Yes. How many of you are with me so far? Just give type out WU in the comment box, which stands for with you. Yes. So now this is what the hero's journey. What is the first technique? A hero's journey. How many of you feel like you yourself have a hero's journey in your own lives? How many of you feel like that? Type out hero's journey, type out HJ in the comment box. If you yourself have the hero inside of you have overcome a lot of those challenges, and you today are leading a totally different life as compared to your parents, as compared to your cousins, as compared to maybe an elder brother or a sister who did not make it happen, but you are living your hero's journey is being written right now. Yes. Then give me an HJ in the comment box, because every single person here has a hero inside, and your journey and your story is being written right now. Yes? Fantastic. I'm so proud of you people. My second technique for you today is show, don't tell. Okay. So when I say show, don't tell, what exactly does this particular thing stands for? This technique actually, asks you to paint a very, very vivid kind of a picture with your words, which means that in order to use this storytelling technique, you have to be very good with your sensory specific words. What are sensory specific words? Anybody knows what are sensory specific words? These are crucial things. Don't miss out on these. Write. Take notes. Sensory specific words are sight words, smell words, taste words, touch words, hearing words, feeling words. These are called sensory specific words. It was an eerie place. It was absolutely dark in there. I could feel the pit of my stomach, or you can say I could feel my heart drop to my feet. I could feel the perspiration, that trickle of sweat go down my spine. That is all these words that I'm using now, these are all sensory specific words. So when you're feeling cold, when you're feeling warm, when you're feeling scared, when you're smelling something, when you're tasting something, when you're hearing something, when you touch something rough, when you touch something satiny smooth, all these are sensory specific words. Now, how many of you can promise me from this day forward, you will do some homework today or maybe tomorrow, you will do some homework on what kind of sensory specific words are there? Seeing words, hearing words, smelling words, tasting words, touching words, feeling words. Will you do this? Between today and tomorrow, will you do this homework of finding out what kind of sensory specific words are there? If you want to be an awesome storyteller, this is something which is non-negotiable. You have to be able to use words that allow the experience for the audience to come alive. Think of it as six senses. And some of you are wondering, Pallavi, five senses hote hai na? No, six hote hai. There's something that you feel in your gut. There's something that you, when you're scared, when you're happy, when you're excited, what do you feel in your gut, inside, or what do you feel when you're in a place and you know something really awesome is going to happen or something really bad is going to happen, goosebumps and all of that? What is that? That is that sixth sense. Okay, so therefore six senses. Okay, so now why do you think some authors are really, really good? You know, because of this only, because of the fact that they allow people to experience the words that you're reading and you're creating your entire imagery around those words. So you need to create the experience. You need to share your story in such a manner with your audience so that they can experience through actions, through the words. They can experience actions, they can experience senses, they can experience feelings, they can experience your thoughts. They don't want to just go through the story ekdam blandly. That's not what you want. And this is a style that actually will make your story much, much more immersive. It's very engaging. It is inviting your audience towards you constantly and towards also drawing their own conclusions, towards also having their own imagery. They become a lot more emotionally invested in your narrative when you are using the show, don't tell kind of a technique. Got it? Now I'm going to give you one small narrative, okay? Gia peeked around the old oak tree, her heart racing. Her eyes sparkled with mischief as she spotted her cousin looking out for her. Sneaking quietly, she did not make a sound. And suddenly, she jumped out, shouting, "Boo!" It was a dark room, and her cousin, though she's 25, jumped up in surprise and ran out of that room. And suddenly realized Gia's laughing, rolling on the floor. And she came right next to Gia and rolled on the floor laughing too. Okay, now I've just given you something with my daughter Gia's name in it. And this is something that I tried to create in a slightly more, how would you say, bookish format. You can say the same thing in your own way. I would say the same thing when I'm narrating this story to my husband. I would say that. But did you notice the sensory specific words that were being used? That is very crucial for me. Okay. All right. Next one, next one, next. Let's go right ahead. In medias res. Now, in medias res basically is not English, but in English it stands for in the midst of it all. So this is a storytelling technique where you will not start and go, this happened first, that happened next, then that happened. No, you are not going to do that. You know how you're going to do this in the midst of things? You're going to start the story from the middle of all the action. You're going to be starting right in the middle of all the action, and that's how you're going to catch the audience's attention. All right. And then, after you've hooked them in because you're bang in the middle of all the action, you will then tell your little bit of your backstory. So, you will do a little bit of flashback. You will tell about, okay, how, that flashback then comes to the present, and then you might want to use some dialogues. This is another technique. All right. So you are creating effective and very, very immediate engagement. You're also creating suspense because you're bang in the middle of the action. They don't know what has happened before. They don't know what is going to happen next. And you are in the heart. You have taken your audience right in the middle. That means the heart of the story. Okay. So to give you an example of this one, again, I'm taking Gia's example and I'm saying, Gia stood at the edge of the diving board. And this has actually happened. Okay. So this was this one time when Gia had to dive into the swimming pool. All right. And she was petrified because she was a very good swimmer, but diving was not something that she had done. She was scared. I could see that she had, you know, her toes, you know, when we stand just as we are about to jump off, how our toes try to grip that edge of that diving board. That's exactly how she was. She was staring down at the water. I could tell from wherever I was sitting that her stomach had kind of gone in because she was kind of holding something. And then suddenly I saw her closing her eyes. And all she remembered was the previous, you know, practice sessions that she had had with her coach, where he had taken her fear of jumping from such a height into the swimming pool out of her. And she had thoroughly enjoyed that entire experience. And she had laughed around, she had splashed around, she, you know, hugged her coach, she hugged her nanu, especially her nanu was in the pool at that time with her as well. She hugged her nanu, she had tears through in the swimming pool as well. And then I saw her opening her eyes, she took one deep breath and she dove right in. And I was so, so, so happy, so proud of her, because at that point in time, I knew that she had overcome that particular fear of hers. Okay. So this is how you could be talking about the in the midst of the action kind of a story. All right. So somebody shared a file. Ah, okay. You've shared a file. Thank you very much for sharing that file. Now, how many of you are a little more relaxed that, Alisha, I've given you three examples for three different techniques of storytelling. I don't know whether you were here or not. How many of you understood the three examples? How many of you understood the three examples? Ah, yes, yes. Okay. You also understood it, right? Okay. Give me yes in the comment box if you understood the three examples of these three different techniques of storytelling. Yes. Hero's journey, show, don't tell, and in medias res, which basically means in the midst of the action. Okay, now is the time when we get to telling stories. Okay, how many of you are ready for action? Because this action is happening with you, not with me. Okay, I'm going to put you people into breakout rooms and I am going to make you do stuff. So because when you tell stories, you win hearts, right? Now, this is what I want you to do before you get into the breakout room. Come on, everybody. Do you have your notepad and pen ready, everyone? Do you have your notepad and pen ready? I want you to, and if you don't have your notepad and pen ready, I want each and every one of you to actually go ahead and get your notepad and pen, because this is so crucial. This is where I'm helping you create an emotional timeline storytelling. Okay, so this is that, this is called that. And when I want you to create an emotional timeline, okay, so many people now they attend this particular session just to learn the techniques and all of that. And when it comes time to practice, they gayab ho jate hain. They leave the room. It's all right. That's up to them. Okay. When you set an intention, you make sure that you're here to practice all your stuff in an interactive setup. Okay. So everybody ready with your book and pen? Give me a BP in the comment box. Give me BP in the comment box, which stands for book and pen. Ready? Type out BP, please. Everyone. So far, whatever has been happening, is it adding value to you? Give me VVV in the comment box if it's adding value to you so far, whatever has been happening. Yes, fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. Super, super, super. Awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, now let's go forward. So now what I want you to do, okay, this is very crucial, because I know for a fact that when you start creating your emotional timeline, so when I say emotional timeline, I want you to just draw one straight line. Okay, so please draw one straight line, like not vertical, but a horizontal line on that piece, on that paper in your notepad. Can you do that at this point in time? Can you draw that straight line? And I want you to mark some significant points. Now, I don't want you to just randomly mark points. Start at the very start. Obviously, you will not remember things when you were 0 or 1 or 2 years young. Maybe you won't. Maybe from the time that you were about 5 years or 6 years young, or maybe from the time that you were about a teenager, or at the time that you were in school or in college. I want you to just mark out 5. Okay, just mark out 5 for right now. You can delve deeper into this. Mark out 5 points on that line, and whether it was a positive or a negative emotion, I don't care about that at this point in time, because this is going to allow you to delve deeper. I want you to, when you put that one strike on that timeline, I want you to just briefly, in 3-4 words or maybe in one line, write what happened. So I'll give you an example. Okay. I was about 9 or 10 years young. And we used to have this tree right opposite our home. I used to live on the first floor in Railway Colony. And we used to have this beautiful tree with yellow flowers. How many of you have played those with yellow flowers? You used to put those yellow flowers in your fingers and you used to act like you were the Rakshasa, or you were, you know, some kind of a whatever. Have you done that? Yes, I have done that. Okay. So there was this tree over there. And we always used to play boys, girls, everybody together. Okay. And most of the families there were very sporting kind of families. So there was this one kid who was throwing stones to bring down the flowers. We tried shaking it. The tree was very stoic and the flowers wouldn't come down. So he tried to throw stones and bring down the flowers. And I was standing right there, right under the tree, like one nut job. That, hello, somebody's throwing stones, na? So move away from there. I stood right there and one nice one landed right here. Okay. And believe me, the next thing I knew, I did not realize the impact, but the next thing I knew, I was standing somehow and suddenly on my hand, I see blood. Tap, tap, tap. The minute the blood started flowing, I started screeching and crying. Before that, that impact, that hurt, that pain, nothing had happened. But the minute that started, I started crying. So now you realize that that was a timeline in my life. And of course, then everybody, obviously, it was not a sad thing or whatever. It was something that happened as an incident. But I realized that, you know, I was so foolish. Or that's how children probably are. They don't see that. It's only when something happens or when somebody shouts, that's when, you know, they get understood. They understand what has happened. Like that, going forward, I can put one thing on the timeline saying 2012, when my husband and I were completely bankrupt. Completely means completely. Whatever we had earned, which was in crores, we gave to somebody we trusted. That person ran away with all our money. And we were the fools. I can't blame the person. But we were so, so massively bankrupt. We didn't have a home of our own. We were living in a rental. We had to leave that. We had to shift from Mumbai to Pune for the next 6 months to live with my parents. And every single day, I used to see my husband die a few breaths, because it was very difficult for him, though he considers my parents as his parents, but still, right? There was that ego that came in. So that's another thing on the timeline. Got it? Then another thing on the timeline. Then 26 January 2023 on Vasant Panchami, when I launched the Charismatic Communicators Hub, that was another thing on my timeline. So are you understanding, everybody? Have you started creating that timeline? Can you please start creating that timeline? Just create 5 and just write, okay? Just write what exactly is that emotion that is associated with that timeline. Is it joy? Is it sadness? Is it anger? Is it surprise? What is that emotion which is attached to that timeline? Got it? And now, just like I have been able to share with you people, I want, when I put you into breakout rooms, what I want you people to do is I want you to get in with your partner, and only 2 of you in a room, and I want you to pick out just one story from that particular timeline. And I want you to share in complete detail with all the emotions, It's okay to be vulnerable if it's an emotional story. It's okay to laugh like one crazy maniac if it's a humorous story. It's okay to be super scared if it was that kind of a story where you had like, you know, almost you felt like a face to face with some not so great entity, like bhoot types. Bahut logon ke saath hua hai ye, okay? Lots of people have gone through this. Okay. So whatever story you want to share, you need to share with. Absolutely, it is going to be so cool. Agreed. How many of you agree that this is going to be super, super cool? Give me cool in the comment box. Give me cool with a lot of O's and L's if you'd like. Okay. Awesome. Thank you so much. Love you guys. Thank you very much. See, I'm every time I do one interactive thing, half the population, not half, of course, few of the population leave the room saying, "Are baap re, ye kaun karega bhaiya? Humko storyteller banna hai without telling story." So I want to tell everybody who's still here, okay, please, haath jodti hu. Communication is like swimming. Swimming seekh sakta hai koi out of water? No, right? You have to get into the water to learn swimming. Communication theory mein nahi seekh sakte. You have to get into implementation. And if you think that you're going to implement it in your back in your home, I'm guaranteeing you, until and unless you implement in a safe space here, you will never be able to implement it at home or at workplace or directly on stage. Never. So only one code of honor that we will all follow. Whatever your partner has shared with you will remain with you. You will not share it with anybody in your home. You know, you have some other friends in CCH. No, you will not. Whatever your partner has shared with you will remain with you. You will take it to till you pass on. How many of you are okay with that? Type out okay. And there is no challenge with language. You want to speak in English? Tell the story in English. You want to tell the story in English? Tell it in English. You want to tell the story in Hindi? Tell it in Hindi. Speak a language that the opposite person understands. That's all. Please ask your question in the comment box. Because if I start taking questions right now, it's going to be, I won't be able to finish things. Right? Okay. Now, I want you to please understand that you will not even share with me. When you come back now to start sharing, you will not even share with me that, oh, this and this is what my partner said. No, no, no. We don't want to hear that. We want to, once you come back, I want to know what was your experience in sharing your own story. That is what I want to know from people. How many of you are okay with that? Give me okay. One story example. I just gave you one massive story. I gave you one story of somebody hitting that stone on the head. Then I gave you a story of my bankruptcy. Now, if I only keep saying all the stories, then what's the point of you? This is your life story, Baba. Don't share somebody else's life story. You share a time when, I'm going to be very upfront. You share a time when you were really, really mean to your child, if you'd like to. I've shared that kind of a story with you people in the storytelling content, recorded content. I've shared a story when I was when I went through almost 1.5, 2 years of depression, and it was a difficult time in my life. And I really thought that I would lose my family. It was only thanks to my husband that he stayed, okay, that with me. Got it? So my point is just this. All right, super. Ready, 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 everybody. Now let's go right ahead. You don't need to follow any template, Baba. You need to start where the story, you need to understand it. Would you want to say it from bang from where the action happened? You want to use that kind of a thing? Or you want to just describe your story? I'm not asking you to use a particular technique. First, start expressing yourself. First, start telling your story. Then we'll get to technique. Okay? Everybody okay with that? All right. Now, I'm not going to ask any more okays and this and that and everything else. I'm just going to go ahead and make you people go into breakout rooms. Okay, so, oh, oopsie. Yeah. I have some people who got shunted out because of, all right. So, I have, maybe some rooms might just end up having 3 people. So, don't worry about that. Okay. No, actually, I'll make it all going to. I'm creating the rooms and I am going to. What? What just happened here? Why? No. Guys, just give me a second, please. Yeah. All right. So, yes. Yes. I'm ready. If you're ready, I'm opening up the rooms. It is 8:58 right now. I want you people to take 5 minutes for your story. You're going to come back at 9:10. Is that all right, everybody? Opening the rooms right now. You are going to get a prompt on your phone or on your laptop. Don't close that prompt. Please join that breakout room. You will get a prompt. Just join that breakout room, everybody. Awesome. अरे बाबा श्री गौरव, ओके नो प्रॉब्लम, योर चॉइस, प्लीज. रूपम धवन, आर यू हियर? आर यू गोइंग टू बी जॉइनिंग द रूम? रूपम धवन, आर यू हियर? आर यू गोइंग टू बी जॉइनिंग द रूम? प्लीज शेयर विथ मी. रूपम, आर यू गोइंग टू बी जॉइनिंग द रूम? पीपल कम इन टू माई सेशंस एंड दे डू नॉट आंसर मी. दैट्स नॉट डन. ओके नो प्रॉब्लम. भारती, Why haven't you gone into your room, Baba? So many of you have not joined your room. Why have you done that? Arey guys, please have some patience. Wait in your own rooms. Okay. Just wait. No, there are times when people take a little longer to go ahead and. Chalo, anyways. Okay. Let me just check which room to actually put you in. Yep. Okay. Jharna, you're here still. Why can't you go to your particular room, Jharna? Jharna, I'm going to give assign one room to you. Please go into that room. Can you type out why is Jharna not going anywhere? Can you please type out if you're not able to unmute? You're in a party. Okay. Mr. Naidu, why are you not in your room? Can you please help me understand? Deep, Rupam Dhawan, Guneet, why are you people not in your rooms, may I ask? All right. Deepak, JP. Okay, you're at work. All right. No problem. JP, why are you not in your room? Deepak, JP. Guneet. Hi, Bharti. There is nobody here in your room.
No, ma'am, no.
Okay, fine. I'll change your room. What was the experience like, Khushbu, for you?
Ma'am, it was wonderful, and I think we had a similar kind of thing that we shared, and
Okay.
yeah, and I think we shared the same experience a little bit here and there. I also got hurt by my own kid in his own on his own birthday with a stone in Leh Ladakh, and
Oh.
my
Oh my
granddad had two
God.
stitches, so. Like that, and she also had something. Not like she had an accident. She was driving with her brother, and then
Okay.
she, yeah. So that was something that, and I told her that I always try to find out why it happened with me, and somehow I was, you know, trying to because I believe in all the God, ma'am. Okay, but for Buddha, for God, Buddha, I was in Buddhist temple. Okay, for him, I was thinking. Yeah, he was a human or he was a god, and like that, I was not able to connect with him, you know. And then he showed me then and there, because I relate everything to like kuch toh, something was there, but
Right,
he made
right.
me hurt. I didn't feel anything, no hurt, nothing, ma'am. And a bunch of doctors were there to help me, protect me, take me. So
Awesome.
everything, I felt protected, but I
Awesome.
got a lesson. Okay, he's a god.
Yeah, that's great. What about you, Kavita? You want to unmute yourself and Moshumi, you've come right back. She, poor thing, was struggling with her internet, and I sent her into your room. Finally, she went into your room, and you're out now. Are Baba, people have some patience, no? Yes, Kavita, you want to share?
Yes, ma'am. So it was almost a similar story, and it was like we learn each for everything from each other's story, like how strong like universe puts us into the same story and just tells us like how strong you have you are in the in your own life. So that
Yes.
is the one thing that we have learned from each other's story.
Fantastic, fantastic, awesome. I want, as people are coming back after this beautiful experience of sharing your story with your partner or partners, I want you people to start writing in the comment box, what was your experience like? I want you to write your experience. I don't want you to tell me anybody's story. I want you to write your experience. How was the experience for you? What did you people experience while you were sharing your story? And nice is not an experiential word. So please use adjectives like was it moving? Did it feel very real? Did you feel connected to the person? Did you have, you know, what kind of an experience did you people have? I want you to write in those many words. Story, you get engrossed till the end of the story. That's, yes, absolutely. And then you're also wanting to know what's next, what's going to come up next. It's a little bit of a suspense, right, with the story. How sweet is that, Jitendra? You went into your childhood days. That's beautiful. Felt connected to the person. Thank you, Dimple, for writing that. Networking happened. Very good. You ran out of time, Asavari. Yeah, some of you are really big storytellers, and I'm happy about that. But you know, one more thing that I'm teaching you by giving you these timelines for sharing is how you need to be able to share everything in the given timeline. Because when we go over as well, it's not going to help us. Yes. So always make sure that you are your timelines are maintained, right? Great experience, fantastic, amazing sharing, amazing session, nice. It creates curiosity to listen more. Good. Maza aa gaya. How sweet is that? I like that. Maza aa gaya. Relived our childhood. Good one, good one. I completed my story on time. Fantastic, Asha. Very good. I felt connected. Mere bachpan ki yaadein aa gayi. Yes, absolutely. I shared my memory, how I met my wife at the. Oh, that's so beautiful. Great way to know people and understand others. Yes, that's correct. And I'm able to connect. Small world. She knew my hometown. That's fantastic, isn't it? Very interesting. Ran out of time and went back to childhood days. That's good. Both of us kept talking. Rena, yes, I trust I asked to do that for sure. And Rena, you anyways are in sales, so you're also going to be, you know, able to do that as well. So that's amazing. Alicia, you met your accountability partner. Wow, that's fantastic. It was awesome. Thank you for the heart, Aradhana. Felt joyful while listening to your partner, laughed a lot, very good. Felt living those incidences while telling the story. Yes, that's exactly what I wanted you all to do. I wanted you to live the experience. When you live the experience, when you live those instances, other people live those instances, Baba. Got it? Oh, that's, I'm sorry about that, Parveen. That Moshmi story couldn't complete. That's, you're so welcome, Sharanya. It was a very nice story connected to school and college. Awesome, awesome, awesome. One of the members was, oh, that's so sweet. That's so sweet. Thank you so much, Manish, for sharing. So loads and loads of people have shared stories from their heart. And, oh, you missed out on Aarti's story. I can't help it, yeah. Some of the people. Okay, guys, when I put you into rooms, na, are Baba, thoda sa patience rakho na. There are people who are trying to figure out this breakout room thing is new for them. Then they stay there only. Then they tell me, okay, send me to the room. Then you're still waiting alone in that room. And then I have to reassign them to some other room and then bring them back to your room. Till the time they've gone to your room, you've come out. Hey Baba, thoda patience rakho, because that is, I cannot help it. There are some people who do not know this system as well. Okay, so please, please, please have some patience, huh? Okay, now my next my next thing that I want y'all to do. Are you ready? Are you ready? I want, oh, okay, sorry, this was like this. Very sorry, well, huh? I want you to have the object memoir. This is one type of telling, one way of telling your story. Okay. And just by the way, I want you to understand that this storytelling format, now you can use when you go with your friends on picnic. I know that Nidhi went with her friends on picnic. There were about 17 of them and they practiced certain humorous wala things, interaction wala things that I had given them. And they had so much fun. The same thing you can do with storytelling as well. Believe me when I say this. Okay. So I want you people to start practicing this in your real lives. Okay. I want you to also start practicing this in your offices, if you want to build your teams, you know, like building a rapport with your teams, with your teammates. Beautiful idea to tell stories. Okay, that's amazing. Okay, no problem, Jarna. That's perfectly fine. All right. So I want to be able to share with you what exactly is the object memoir. This is fun. Okay, this is a lot of fun. So I want you to select an object right now before you go into your room. I want you to think about one particular object and I want you to select an object that holds some kind of significance, some kind of emotional value. It could be happy emotional value. It could be sad emotional value. Sad ka ab rakhoge kyun, right? But sometimes people do keep it. It could be angry emotional value. It could be any emotion. It could be fearful emotional value. It could be anything. So I'll, so let me share with you something that I have here. Oh, hold on. Yeah. Yes. Okay. This is fantastic. This is the book that my mentor's book, okay? And it's, why does it have so much emotional value for me? After doing whatever I was doing for 26 years of my life, being like one of the most sought after MCs in India, covering the ICC Cricket World Cup and the Milan Fashion Week in Italy and blah, blah, blue, blue, I still felt empty. I still felt like I'm not living my purpose, my higher purpose. And I just did not know what to do. Every day I used to sit and I used to cry with my husband. What, yeah, there's so much potential. What am I doing with my life? What am I doing with my life? Where am I going? What is happening? Tomorrow, if I die, nobody's going to even remember. What have I passed on? What have I done? I wanted to make my parents so proud. I wanted to make India proud. What have I done, yeah? Okay, parents are proud. Bacha settled hai. She's doing some great events. But what am I doing to really live my higher purpose? And that's when my mentor had invited me to MC his, like host his 2-day community event. At that 2-day community event, October 2022, my life changed forever. And I can never, never, never thank him enough. I stood backstage and somebody from stage, one of the speakers from stage shared, Don't get married to your niche. I'll tell you what the significance of that statement is. My mentor was a friend of mine, a trainer friend since 2017. And in 2019, I was approached by one of the finest organizations in India and today even in the world. They have a very clear vision, bringing the best trainers from the world to India and taking India's best trainers to the world. Success Gyan, I'm talking about, okay? Success Gyan had chosen me as one of their virtual trainers. And the niche that I had picked up was I wanted to help more people to have an on-stage presence. Either you want to become an MC or you want to be a speaker on stage or whatever. I wanted people to get away from that fear of being on stage. And I wanted them to sizzle the stage, like literally ace the stage. And 2019, obviously, I got started off. I had a good amount of students already. And then what happened? The pandemic happened. And when the pandemic happened, obviously, the thing that I was doing and the thing that I was teaching, who wanted to be on stage? Abhi kisi ko pata bhi nahi tha whether the stages will open up, how many years will it take? 2 years, 3 years, how many years will it take? Nobody knew. We did not have horizons. And that was the time that I chickened out. And I don't have any qualms sharing this with you people. I was such a coward. Because my funnel did not do well, I did not go back to the drawing board. I just let go. I did not even have the courage to face my now mentor, Siddharth Rajsekar, because he was building us up in this online space. How do you do it? And this, that, and the other. And when he asked me to host his event in 2022, first and foremost, I'll tell you this. I'll give you a backstory. He sent me a voice note in April 2022. I didn't open that voice note for 7 days. I was so petrified. I was so scared. I was like, kis muh se, what face will I take in front of this gentleman who selflessly was teaching us? I didn't even have the courage to go back. Decency. What courage? I didn't even have the decency to go back and tell him, Siddharth, I don't think that I can, I'm ready to do this. Because I'm too shattered. I feel like, oh, you've done this for 20 years and now you're an utter failure in this. I was not an utter failure. There was a pandemic. But that's how I had spoken to myself. After 7 days, I opened, finally got the courage to open Siddharth's message. I heard the message. He wanted me to host his today event for his community, which was the first event that he was doing for his community. I felt so happy, and I can't tell you, I was in the flight when I opened that message. I was reading it, and continuously I was taking a flight to Goa for my event. I was crying on the flight just of happiness that, oh my God, this man is so forgiving. He has not held anything against me. And I hosted that event, and that day what was happening on stage was I introduced the speaker. The speaker from stage said, I remember the speaker's name, Abhinav Saxena. He said from stage, don't get married to your niche. It's okay to change. And that hit me like one bolt. Siddharth was sitting on the chair in front of me. I looked at the stage. I turned around and looked at Siddharth. And I literally was so overwhelmed. I said, Sids, I really want to be back. This is what I want to be doing. I want to be a coach. And he turned around and told me, Pallavi, you are ready. It's your time. That was October 2022. And 26th January 2023, I launched Charismatic Communicators Hub. My life has changed because of my mentor. So I just want you people to know this book. That is why it is of so much significance. And I always keep it right here next to me as a constant reminder that he's the man who changed my life. He's my Sarathi. He's my mentor. But also as a constant reminder that that moment changed my life. The moment I took that decision that, yes, I want to be the coach. And he said, your family, welcome back. You can do this. I know it. So I want you people to look for some kind of an object. It could be a chain, it could be a, you know, it could be something, yeah, your phone, it could be something around you. Just look for it right now. And as I send you into your breakout room, I want you to share with your partner what is the significance of that, that whatever you've picked up. What is the significance? Why are you so attached to it? How has it turned your life around? Or whatever it is, what's the story behind it? Yes. So it has, does it have a special meaning? Then express that special meaning. How you present your that special object, that's what this entire story is, this entire exercise is about. Okay, so please delve into the details when you're talking about that thing, right? Like I went into details. What mechanism did I use? Can you anybody tell me? Where did I start the story? Did I start the story right at the beginning? Or did I start the story? Where did I start the story? I started the story in the midst of the action. Yes or no? How many of you agree with me in the midst of the action? Thank you so much for sharing. Yes, I started the story in the middle of this action, right? And then from there, I took you on a flashback. And then from there, I brought you here. Yes, now that is a way of sharing the story. So I just want you to know that you can use, the name of the book is You Can Coach by Siddharth Raj Sekar. Okay, the name of the book is You Can Coach. I'm sorry, I did not read your messages. No, only now I'm reading these messages. Yes, so sure, Pritam, we'll talk about that for sure. Yeah, so now I love you too, all of you. Thank you so much for writing such beautiful stuff. Okay, so whatever you want to share, you share. Don't worry about it, but go into details. Okay, remember what is the object of that story. Try and see what is the object of that story. Try and remember what sounds can you hear at that time when that thing was happening. What sights could you see around yourself when that thing was happening? What were you able to smell when that thing was happening? And then how has that impacted? How has that one thing, that one story impacted your life? How has it impacted maybe your identity? My story has impacted my identity. I am a different person today. Yes? Everybody ready for this? Yes? Now, tangible object, ideally tangible object. Okay, Nilesh? Ideally. Agar nahi mila tangible object, to phir kya hi koi kar sakta hai, right? Don't worry about it. Okay? All right. Let's get straight into this. I want to see how many of you are here. I want to put ideally two people in a room. So let me just go right ahead and give you different breakout rooms altogether. Okay. Different breakout rooms altogether. Recreate. Okay. Ready, everybody. I'm recreating the rooms and I'm going to open these rooms. It's 9:27. You will come back at 9:40. Okay? Five minutes for each of you to share the story. Whichever room has three people, I'm so sorry about that. Yeah. Go. I've already given you the prompt to go. Go into your rooms, please. Okay, person bhi ho sakta hai. No problem. Chalo. Given. Asavari, if you're still here, I don't know whether you want to show that. My object was right here. That is why I showed it to you people. You may or may not want to show. Superb. Go, everybody. Into your rooms. Off you go. Your partners are waiting for you.